Hi Gemini, welcome to Pandora Astrology's monthly horoscope for September of 2020. Mars has gone retrograde for real, and you may be one of those, you know, cerebral people who thinks that you never get angry, but Mars might change your mind. Julia will tell you all about that, and I'll be talking about the moons, the new and full moons this month, and then also we'll throw some stuff in there about Mercury and Venus for you. Hey Julia, what's up for Gemini this month with that crazy Mars?
Oh, sure. Well, hey there, Gemini. So Mars is going retrograde in the sign of Aries on September 9th, and that all correlates with your 11th house. That's the house of groups. So professional associations, clubs, societies, if you're a member of a bowling team, that would count. Any group you're a part of, also friends. And it's also the house of long-term goals. And whenever Mars goes retrograde, it brings a lot of frustrations. It can bring a lot of conflict. So that could mean that this is a time where you get into some fights with your buddies or have some issues with any type of group that you're a part of. And it can also mean that you could find this period extra frustrating in terms of advancing towards a long-term goal that you have. You might have to redo some part of it, for example. Between September 10th and 12th, actually all of the outer planets, including Mars, are going to go retrograde at once. So this is something where during the month of September, especially during that window of time, it's probably not a good idea to just start anything new, like expand a business or buy a new home or something like that, because you're going to get all those retrogrades in the inception chart, in the election chart of whatever you start new. So better just to kind of keep going on the same track you're used to. And actually, Jamie and I did a Mars retrograde triggering the pandemic hot degree video, and it's in our 2020s news playlist, and it talks about how the cycle is going to affect the world at large. Now, Mercury, the planet of communication, is actually very direct and fast this month, and it enters Libra on September 5th, which is your fifth house of games. And Mercury loves to play games, so your mind is going to be on fun, whether you do crosswords, whether you're part of a role-playing video games, instead of getting down to work. And it's also good if you do any kind of creative mental work, like writing too, because the fifth house is about all types of creative output. And Venus, excuse me, Venus, the planet of art and beauty, is also direct and fast this month. She enters Leo on September, kind of between September 5th or 6th. It depends on your time zone. Sure. But this is all happening in your third house. This is the house of siblings. This is the house of your neighborhood. This is also the house of communication. So it's going to be great, even if you're having fights with your friends during this cycle. At least Venus in the third means that you'll know how to be somewhat diplomatic in your communications, and that's definitely going to help. And if you have any brothers or sisters, even cousins ruled by this house too, then this should be a nice period where you're all just getting along really well together.
Yeah, that could feel pretty good. It's nice to get along with your siblings. I think it's too rare too. So back to September 1st, because there is a moon happening there. And so the month begins with this full moon in Pisces. You can see it right there in the 10th house, bringing powerful moods and strong feelings to the arena of career, the way that full moons tend to do, opposed to a sun here in the fourth house. And this particular moon has a super nice grand trine in Earth built right into it, from the sun over here to Pallas Athena and over here to Uranus and back to the sun. And so we are calling this one dreaming plus strategic action. And the dreaming is going to be happening for you in the, you know, usually rather concrete area of career. So while this moon is happening, like right around the last day of August and the first and second days of September, is a really good time to kind of revision your career. And then you should, you know, get some stuff that you can put into practice. Now, halfway through the month, we have got a new moon. And there it is in Virgo. You can see it happening there in the fourth house. House of home and family, domestic life, heritage, and roots, and new moons bring new beginnings. This particular moon has a very strong feeling of integrity built right into it, and the sun and the moon meet up in mid to late Virgo, and from that position, they form a trine to the pandemic hot degree, so that there is we've been talking this year about the lesson of the pandemic hot degree, that, like, you know, we're all having a spiritual lesson right now under this pandemic, and sometimes it's pretty scary. But this moon should really bring some, it should plant some new seeds that are helpful and supportive and soothing. So I think that's a pretty nice new moon right there. And that it's landing in your fourth house suggests that there may be help regarding family connected with that for you specifically. Well, Gemini, if you wanted a reading, the Natal and Transit reading is the best one to answer the myriad of questions that might come up. There aren't really any one, one or few places that the themes of this month are happening. Like, if it was all about relationships, I'd tell you. If it was all about career, I'd tell you that too. But it's kind of all over the place. So probably just a Natal and Transit reading would be the one to answer any questions that you might be having. And you can find that on our website, pandoraastrology.com/services. You can have readings with me or Julia. And you can always find horoscopes like this one on our website at pandoraastrology.com/horoscopes, on our YouTube channel too, Pandora Astrology, where you will find the news happening on our channel as well. And until next month, we'll see you around the cosmos. Bye.
Bye-bye.